that who are neither anbiya and shuhada, but they will have the rank when the anbiya and the shuhada will marvel at their position on the day of qiyamah. So he said, these people are neither anbiya and shuhada, but anbiya and shuhada will marvel at them. So he sat there, you know, he sat down and he's like, smack, you know, hit his hand on his thighs there and on the floor there, like to show excitement. And he said, oh, Prophet of Allah, describe them for us. Tell us who these people are. Give us their description. This is the other words of the hadith. Right? And it's the narration says that when this man showed this excitement and so on, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's face became joyful at this man's enthusiasm and at his request to describe these people that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was speaking about. Going back to the narration of Umar ibn Khattab, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قالوا يا رسول الله تخبرنا منهم. O Prophet of Allah, inform us, who are these people? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave an answer. He said, قال هم قوم تحابوا بروح الله على غير أرحام بينهم. He says, these are a group of people who love one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without having any biological and genetic and relationship with one another. They're not related to one another. They're not part of the same tribe, they're not part of the same gaon, they're not part of the same family, they're not part of the same clan. They have no biological ties whatsoever with one another. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَلَا أَمْوَالٍ يَتَعَاطُونَهَا. And he said, nor do they have any business ties, business links, you know, that we do business together. You know, I benefit you, you benefit me there. I'm making a profit off you, you're making a profit off. Nothing. They don't have any property ties, no property deals, no business deals, no dealings whatsoever. No blood dealings, no financial dealings whatsoever. The only thing that they have in common is that they love one another for the sake of Allah. That's the only thing that they have in common, that they love one another for the sake of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, for Allah, the Prophet of Allah swore by Allah. He said, inna wujuhahum lanurun. On the day of qiyamah, their faces will be nur. Wa innahum la'ala nur. And they will be on nur. And the narration says, wa hum ala manabirin min nur. And they will be seated on pulpits of light. Manabir, minbar. They will be seated on pulpits of light. Their faces will be nur, wahum ala manabir min nur, wahum ala nur. And they will be seated on minbars of light, pulpits of light. Right? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يخافون إذا خاف الناس. These people, by virtue of their loving one another for sake of Allah, لا يخافون إذا خاف الناس. They will not fear when the rest of creation is fearing. And all of creation will be fearing. وَلَا يَحْزُونَ إِذَا حَزِنَ النَّاسِ. And they will not be sad and grieved and in pain when everyone else will be sad, grieved and pained. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the various ahadith is giving you a snapshot of the day of Qiyamah. Everybody is running helter-skelter looking for an intercessor. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending out an angel there to call those people who loved one another for the sake of Allah. Right? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, come, come, come. We are those people who love one another for the sake of Allah. Come here. Let me give you the shade under my throne, under the arsh of Allah. When they are summoned to Allah and they are beneath the shade of the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what's going to happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't make them stand like everybody else will be standing in safs there. And everybody else will be traumatized and everybody else will be aggrieved. No, no, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated there that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him, no, no, you sit down. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put manabir min nur, pulpits of light for them. And their faces will be illuminated. And whilst everybody else out there is in fear, in anxiety, totally traumatized by the fear of the day of Qiyamah, these people will have no fear. These people will have no grief. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after saying this, وَقَرَى هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after giving this description of these people, the Prophet of Allah then described them from the Holy Quran. And Allah subhanahu, the Prophet of Allah said, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَا اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. The Prophet of Allah recited the verse and he said, you want to know who this category of people are? These are that are not anbiya and shuhada. The Prophet said, these are the awliyaullah. These are the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the beloved ones of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the beauty part of this power of love is this that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam stated in a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam stated there. He says, muttafaq alayhi hadith first. Right? And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Right? He states there, he said, ja'a rajulun ila rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. He said, قال يا رسول الله كيف تقول في رجل أحب قوما ولم يلحق بهم. He said, what do you say about a man who loves a group of people but he has never met them? He's never met them. Look how easy Allah is making. Allah is telling you, don't even think that, you know what, you're going to look for the person in your lifetime. If you didn't meet anyone that you loved purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your lifetime, that's fine, no problem. This man is asking the question, كيف تقول في رجل أحب قوما ولم يلحق بهم. He's never met them. He may be from different eras. They may be from different, you know, ages. ولم يلحق, he's never met them. The Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم said, فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, the Prophet of Allah, when this man asked this question, the فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, المرء مع من أحب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stated, a man will be with the one whom he loves. خلاص. Can you see a pattern emerging? Abu Dharr Ghaffari asked the question. Man doesn't have the deeds to be able to raise himself up to the rank of those people that he loves. The Prophet of Allah said, you will be with the one whom you love. The Prophet of Allah was asked, what have you prepared for Qiyamah? The man said, not enough salat, not enough siyam, not enough sadaqah, but I love Allah and His Rasul. Allah gave the same answer, you will be with the one whom you love. Now the man is saying, Ya Rasulullah, I loved a group of people. I love the Sahaba, I love the Shuhada, I love the Tabi'un, I love the Tab'i Tabi'un, I love the Awliya, but I have never met them. We're not in the same eras. I'm not in the era of Imam al-Hussein. I'm not in the era of Abu Huraira. I'm not in the era of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud or Hassan al-Basri. ومعروف كرخي وعبد القادر الجيلاني. I'm not in the era, but I love them and I've never met them. ولم يلحق بهم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave a fatwa again. أنت المرء مع من أحب. A man will be with the one whom he loves. Why do we underestimate the power of love? And why is it that this deed, this action, this amal of love is not something which is encouraged and prioritized in the ummah, when the rewards for it are practically second to none in terms of any other action that you may perform? Why is it that it's not prioritized? Why is it that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it so easy for us to acquire His love and to be recipients of His love and to be rewarded for His love purely by us loving one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this deed, this action, this amal as salih is not encouraged and prioritized in the ummah? Yet we know full well from muttafaq alayhi ahadith the rewards and the merits of loving one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is it that? Why is it that this ummah is an ummah which is lacking severely in love? Yet I'm telling you, and the Prophet of Allah, Sadaqa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just proved to you on every count that loving a person, whether you reach the spiritual rank in terms of deeds, still qualifies for their ma'iyyah on the day of Qiyamah. Whether you've never met them, you still qualify for it. Whether you haven't prepared enough in terms of your good deeds there, you will still be reunited with them. Right? And Allah says that in the dunya, you will be a recipient, and Allah will make it incumbent upon Himself to love you for because you loved one another for His sake. Why is that not encouraged and prioritized? Our deen, the foundation, the asas of this deen is on love. And the foundation of our deeds should be centered around and focused around this love, mutual love for one another. And obviously the highest ranking of love that we can have for any created being out there is Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And wallahi, I'm giving you a ranking here. How to love and who to love. Right. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walidihi wa waladihi wa an-nasi ajma'in wa nafsihi wa an-nasi ajma'in." Right? The Prophet ﷺ said, none of you can perfect his faith and complete his faith until love for me supersedes love for his father, his sons, and all of humanity put together. What is he telling you? The basis of your iman and the completion of your iman, right, is dependent on you loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam more than anyone and more than anybody else created being in the universe. After Allah, you love Rasulullah. That's where the completion and the perfection of your faith is. The Prophet of Allah, I'm giving you the ranking now. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the Sahaba, Allah fi ashabi. Fear Allah concerning my Sahaba. Allah fi ashabi. Fear Allah concerning my Sahaba. لا تتخذوهم غردا بعدي فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fear Allah concerning my Sahaba after me, and don't make them a cause of, don't make them the targets of your insult after me. He spoke about Sahaba. Don't make them the targets of insult after me. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّي أَحَبَّهُمْ. Whosoever loves them, love them by virtue of the fact that you love me. If you love me and you say you don't love my Sahaba, your claim to loving me is what you call it, is faulty. Sahaba al-Kiram. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, in numerous ahadith from amongst the Sahaba al-Kiram, ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, the highest ranking people, this was Sahaba in general, the highest ranking people from amongst the Sahaba al-Kiram, ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, who are worthy of our love are four people. Ali, Fatima, Hassan, and Hussein. For nobody else, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Allahumma inni uhibbuhuma fa ahibbahuma." Ya Allah, I love these two. So you love these two. Wa ahibba man yuhibbuhuma, and love those who love these two. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam singled them out. He singled them out. Right? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the Hasan Gharib hadith. By the way, this hadith of the Sahaba kiram is Hasan Gharib. You know, people will get technical. The Sahabi's hadith is Hasan Gharib. This hadith is also Hasan Gharib, both in Tirmidhi. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man ahabbani, whosoever loves me, wa ahabba hadaini, and loves these two." At that time, he's holding Imam Hussein in his arms, and he's holding the hand of Al-Hasan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. "Man ahabbani, wa ahabba hadaini, wa abahuma, and their father, wa ummahuma, and their mother, kana ma'i fi darajati yawm al-qiyamah," will be in my ranking, will be in my position, will be with me on the day of Qiyamah. This is the power of love. This is the power of love. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the awliya. I just gave you the hadith there. Loving the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether they are on earth or whether they're in earth, whether you've met them or whether you've not met them. Purely loving them for the sake of Allah, because they are the beloved ones of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will elevate you to that rank when you will be united with them and you will receive the companionship on the day of Qiyamah. And you'll be placed on marabirin min nur, and pulpits of light, and your face will be full of nur. Do we not want that? Do we not want that? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, if two people love one another, this is in Bayhaqi and Muslim al-Bazzar, right? He said, if two people love one another, wahidun fil mashriq wa wahidun fil maghrib, لَجَمَعَ اللَّهُ بَيْنَهُمَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will unite them on the day of Qiyamah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will unite them in paradise and say, this is the person whom you used to love. You never met him, you never saw him. Now go and see him now. Here's the person you used to love. And see the reward of loving that person. Why is it that this ummah is seeped in hatred? Why is it that this ummah doesn't have the type of love, when the reward of love as a deed, as an amal, carries so much of merit and so much of reward? Why is it that we don't have it? Why is it that every relationship of ours, whether it's a relationship between our parents, between our spouses, between our children, between our family members, between our business acquaintances, why can it not have the foundation of love, not on tab'i love, not on fitri love, that, you know, I love my child because that's part of me. I love my father because that's my father or my mother, right? It's all tab'i, it's nature, it's your fitra. Why can it not be based, firstly and most importantly, I love my father for the sake of Allah. I love my mother for the sake of Allah. I love my brother and I love my daughter for the sake of Allah. The only reason why I love all of them is I love them for the sake of Allah first and foremost. My first, My natural طبيعي and طبيعة and my fitra come second, but my motivation for loving them, I love for the sake of Allah. You know, I always say this to prospective spouse, prospective partners. I say, you know what? Base your foundation of love and your foundation of your relationship on love. So they get very happy. Oh, we must be in love. No. Have you ever heard a man proposing marriage to a woman by saying to her, or vice versa, you know, depending, right? That I love you for the sake of Allah. Do you know what happens? That love that you have for your spouse is raised to a different degree altogether, on a different level. It's on a, in a different league altogether after that. Then when you are, you know, you feel a bit disappointed with them, or they let you down, or you have a bit of a tiff and whatever it is there. What's the motivating factor now? Now it's not your own love that motivates you to incline towards them. Hey, but I love this person for the sake of Allah. And you think of the reward that, you know what, I sit with this spouse of mine for the sake of Allah, it becomes incumbent upon Allah to love me. If I spend on my spouse, it becomes like incumbent upon Allah to love me. Of course, you can't visit your spouse. I need this thing with you. Right? But that's a reality. Why can you not have that? Why is it that we underplay the power, the spiritual power of love? And ask yourself this question there. How many of you truly love? How many of you have truly loved Allah, His Prophet, the Sahaba, like they instructed us, the Ahlul Bayt, with that high ranking that you're going to get by loving them? How many of us have truly loved it? And you know what? Don't tell me, no, no, gee, I love them. Don't let your love be an ambivalent one. Don't it just be from the tongue. No, I love the Sahaba. How? No. The Prophet of Allah says, ثَلَاثٌ مَّنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. I won't narrate the hadith, we don't have time. Three qualities, if found in a person, he will experience the delight and the sweetness of faith. أَنْ يَكُونَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَاهُمَا. That he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anyone else. And the second one, وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْءِ. And he loves a person, لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And he loves him only, purely for the sake of Allah. You will taste the delight and the sweetness of faith. Anyone tasted it here? Anyone tasted it here? The sweetness of faith? Let me tell you what it is. The sweetness of faith is this here. When the name of your beloved, and this is not Allah I'm talking about, I'm talking about a created being. When the name of the beloved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned, your heart skips a beat and your heart goes into ecstasy. And when you hear the name of the beloved Sahaba and the Ahlul Bayt, Hassan and Hussein and Ali and Fatima and so on, there, your heart skips a beat and you can feel the love for them. When the name is mentioned and you want to talk about them, that's when you're tasting sweetness of faith. Up until then there, that tank is empty. That tank is empty. Don't be spiritually diabetic. Don't be spiritually diabetic. Don't let your love be a diluted one. Really, let it be full on. Let it be full on. Right? Because Sayyidina Imam Shafi'i was the same thing there. He says, in كان حب علي محمد رفضا فليشهد الثقلان أني رافضي. Because of the love Imam Shafi'i used to express for the family of the Prophet of Allah, Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein, Ali and Fatima and so on there, the ulama of his time, they gave him a fatwa of him being a Rafidi, being a Shia. So he wrote a whole line, I'm not reading the whole thing, he said, in كان حب علي محمد رفضا. If love for the family of the Prophet of Allah is a sign of being a Shia, فليشهد الثقلان, then let the species of jinn and human beings bear witness that Shafi'i is a Rafidi and a Shia. That's the extent of Shafi'i's love. Anyone got the guts to do that today? Come on. Even when you are fasting, you'll taste the sweetness of love. Not here, inside here. This is what the Ummah needs today. Islam is based on it. Your amal is totally dependent and based on it. Inculcate it. Stop being spiritually diabetic and really, you know, we don't have it. We don't have it. Let these eyes fill up with tears. Let this heart become softened. Let there be love in your life. The love of Allah is the Rasul and the beloved of Allah. That's why the Prophet of Allah made a dua in a one-on-one with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a spiritual mi'raj. وَأَسْأَلُكَ, I read this every night. وَأَسْأَلُكَ in the masjid. وَأَسْأَلُكَ حُبَّكَ, and I ask of you, may Allah, your love. وَحُبَّ مَنْ يُحِبُّكَ, And the love of those whom you love. وحب عملا يقربنا إلى حبك. And the love of those deeds which will bring me closer to your love. That's the dua the Prophet of Allah made on a one-on-one encounter with Allah in the spiritual mi'raj. What more? If the Prophet of Allah is asking of Allah for this, what should we be asking? But what the Prophet of Allah asked. Allah give us tawfiq and hidayah inshallah ta'ala. Eid Salah on Eid.